That's Bone Monkey featuring Dave Alvin, formerly of White Trash, from New York City. I'm Jay Stone. Welcome to my show at rockmetaltalk.com. Don't forget to check me out on the affiliate stations. And we're rolling into another show. It's Thursday. Yes, it's Thursday. I'm fucking exhausted. I'm not going to be doing a very long show tonight. Of course, as soon as I start talking, the messages start coming on the phone. I don't know what the nightmare is, but I'll find out momentarily. I really am exhausted from working the night shift. That's why the show has moved to Thursday temporarily, till I can figure out a better plan. That was brand new Bone Monkey, by the way. It's called Deep Red Juiced. I love Dave Alvin, everything he does. I just posted a video on Facebook of the vinyl I got of White Trash. But I want to play another song, and I want to talk about the compilation CD and a few more things. I just wanted to say, you know, what's going on? What's happening? You want to go get some Chinese food? You know what I'm saying, yo? But, yeah, I just wanted to check in, let you guys know that the show is going to be on Thursdays now. Temporarily, we got the lineup, the plot holes on Friday. We're going to upload Cats and Yama on Saturday. And Prickly Rickly's show is going to start back up on March 14th on Wednesday. He's interviewing Whitney Payton. She's out on tour. So Bakelow's out with them, and Ciro, you know, from Andrew W. Boss, they're all out on the road working that tour. So Andrew Boss is going out on the road again as well in the spring doing a Midwest tour. They are also on the compilation CD along with Bone Monkey. So a lot of people are excited about it. You know, it could be sold out already, but I'm not going to complain. It's, you know, between the bands getting their copies and my therapy and, you know, the few sales that came in, and the rest of the bands that there's like four or five bands that bought additional copies, so it'll pretty much be sold out at that point. There'll be a few copies left if any of the bands want them, and then I have them up on the website. About 100 are going out to retail stores and shit like that. But I'm gonna play Josephine by Chris Cornell, one of my favorite songs off his last solo album. I love to sing it, love to warm up to the song. I actually do pretty good singing the style of music. I just choose to scare the shit out of people. I'm Jay Stone. You listen to my show at rockmetaltalk.com, live from Tarpon Springs, Florida. The smear cream cheese. I'm Jay Stone. You're listening to my show live from Tarpon Springs, Florida at rockmetaltalk.com. That was Josephine by Chris Cornell, one of my favorite songs. So you'll hear some perfect timing with fucking dogs and, groceries coming in. But what are you going to do? I'm live on the air, man. What's going on? What's the nightmare? Huh? What's your nightmare?
Nothing. She went to make you a sandwich, and then she put everything in a baggie, mixed the sauce boxes up and then drops it all on the counter.
I don't know. That's how they do it. They're supposed to put it on bread, not on the counter. I don't know what the hell's going on. A fucking chicken tender sandwich from fucking Publix became a project that I probably won't even eat. It'll come out the same way it went in. The comp CD is in production. It will be shipped, I guess, by the 1st. I don't really know. It was delayed. I was 2 days ahead, and it was delayed 2 days, so it put it on track, because I don't understand how someone can be a professional at laying out artwork and then don't get it in the lines that they're required. Did you not see that you cut off the fucking name of the album? That it was cut completely in half? That featuring Eric Rogers of Stereo Mud? Who was it? It just says I was like blown away at the whole process. It's definitely not an easy process. My fucking shit was timed perfectly. I don't know what happened there. It went over in time, so I had to cut the bonus track. So the bonus track is going to be on the MP3 version. So I'm still working on that. That's more of a pain in the ass than actually putting a CD out. Because you have to run them through some shit to get all the crap off of it and all the filters and all the bands separated artwork and shit. Otherwise, like when I load it into Windows Media Player, it's got artwork from fucking other shit for the bands that are playing. And that shit don't fly with me, so I don't like that. So I may send out WAV files of it. I'm not really sure yet. There's a few record labels that are interested in hearing some of the bands that are on there. I'm also working on some things to possibly be involved in some festivals next year in 2019. So we're going to take that one step at a time. I'll reveal more of that as it moves forward. But this is more about the comp CD and not that. So it's just something that I wanted to do. It looks like we will do volume 2 as long as, you know, I don't mind laying money out as long as the cost is basically covered. And I think I'm pretty much right there. You know, I'm not getting paid back for my time and shit like that, but bands are getting out there, stuff that I'm doing's getting out there, and, you know, it's putting independent music, it's trying to keep something physical that keeps getting diminished in a way, and I'm trying to keep that alive, so to speak, I guess. I mean, it's not an easy process. I understand people don't want CDs, and that's kind of all I'm offering, but